Dear fellows, an energize activity or an icebreaker is used to energize the students in your class. Today we have a question as an energizer. You will put this question or you will ask your students to solve these questions on their own, and in this way this interest will be created in the class. The question is, how many squares are there in an 8x8 chess box? So let's solve this question. To solve this question, I take this side as side 1 and this side as side 2 of the square. Now, first of all, if we take the tiniest square in this chess box, means if I take the dimension as 1x1, then first of all we see that how many squares are there along the side 1 and how many squares are there along the side 2. So let's have a look. Counting the highlighted squares, along the side 1 there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 squares, and along the side 2 there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 squares. So in total we have 8x8 is equal to 64 squares in this chess box, as can be seen right now. I've made a table along the right hand side in which we will write the dimensions and the number of squares along the side 1 and the side 2, and hence the total squares. Now that dimension is 1x1, and how many squares we had on the side 1? Yes, 8. And on the side 2 we had 8 squares. So we multiply them 8x8 and we get 64 squares. Now we take the dimension of the square as 2x2. And we try to see that how many squares we have along the side 2 and the side 1. You can see that we have overlapping squares over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we have 7 squares along the side 2, and similarly we will have 7 squares along the side 1. Like this, we have overlapping squares 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. It means there are 7 squares along the side 2 and 7 squares are there along the side 1. It means that if we have dimension as 2x2, we have 7 squares along the side 1 and 7 squares along the side 2, hence we get 7x7 as 49 squares. Now we take the dimension as 3x2, and here you go, if we take the squares of dimension 3x3, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 squares. It means that 6 along the side 1 and 6 along the side 2. So in total we get 6x6 as 36 squares. Now you can observe that as we are increasing the dimension of the squares, the number of squares along the side 1 and the side 2 are decreasing by 1. So it means we are using the formula of n/1. So automatically when we take the dimension as 4x4, we get here 5x5, hence 25 squares. If we take the dimension as 5x5, we get 4x4 over here, it means 16 squares. If we take the dimension as 6x6, here we get n-1, which means 3x3, so we get 9 squares. If we take the dimension as 7x7, we get here 2x2, which means 4 squares. And if we take the dimension as 8x8, we get 1x1, which means 1 square. And we can also demonstrate it like this. If we take the dimension as 8x8, it means 8 squares along the side 1 and 8 squares along the side 2, hence we get only 1 square, which can be seen here. So at the end we will add all these number of squares to get the total number of squares that we can have in this chess box. So let's do By adding them all, we get 204 squares. So our answer is 204 squares. I hope you found it interesting. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel, Maths with Ms. Sumbel, and please like the video. Thank you.